All right, everyone. It's time to record Tarantula Feeding Video 125. It's super late, but we are going to feed all those lovely tarantulas and scorpions and centipedes for you.
That's awesome. All right, so it's time to record the loving feeding video. Unfortunately, all of these tanks here are currently empty for the moment. We did get some passings, but anyways, I can't wait to feed all those tarantulas. They haven't been fed in quite some time, so away we go. Anyways, to some people that kind of may be a little bit cheesy, but I thought I should make a nice little intro to this feeding video. So, the very first seed we're going to be feeding is my 6-inch female Tarantulochilus marinus red form, which is named the OBT, or the orange bitey thing. Alright, so I have a nice super worm. And let's see if... Oh, nice. There we go. Got that one. Nice species from Africa. And this is going to be hard to see, but I'll try to feed this one anyway. This is my female Tapnicinius gigas orange tree spiders. Yeah, they're sure hungry, but anyway, let's get this guy, girl, fed. Barb, she's about 3.5 inches. Oh, there we go. Didn't really see a great attack from this one. She's chilling over there with the super sweet. Righty, this one here is my centipede. Ooh, scary. Now, this one here is a Scolopendra suspinips, which is the giant Vietnamese. Yeah, just about 6 inches. Oh yeah, this one was hungry. Not a spectacular attack, but an attack no less. And you can see the modified fangs, which serve as their very first pair of legs. Yep, and they just inject venom, and they have mandibles, so they go choo-choo-choo. Like the scorpions do. Even though that they're kind of called centipedes, they don't really have 100 legs. These guys have like, I don't know, 23 pairs, so that makes 46 of them. Yeah, scary for some people, but pretty cool to my new collection. One of my favorite species of tarantulas that I keep are the pokies. Now, this one here is a female Poclotheria fasciata. This is this Sri Lankan ornamental that I named Lucky. I know Lucky's a male's name, but I don't know, after 7 tries to getting a female, I lucked out on this one. There she is. Come on, come on, baby. Yay! Nice. I was waiting for her to attack. And that's her. Very, very fast poke. Alright, this one here is the Hystericrates gigas Cameroon red baboon. One of my largest African species I have so far. it. And her name is Elena. Aw, so gentle. Yet this is not a species that you would love to handle. So cute. Hey, this guy's my blue bomber. this is a Phonopelma simani, which is a Costa Rican zebra. Unknown sex, so I believe it could be male, but I have to check the molt next time. It does. He's a pretty strong eater, so we should get him to eat. And there you go. Nice one. I got this one at the Reptile Expo back in March. Sweet. Now this one here. Monocentropus balfouri! The golden leg blue baboon. One of my rare ones. Not the rarest. But still pretty beautiful. This is a 4.5 inch female. Oh, look at that. She's coming to say hi to us. Oh, perfect. Come on. Come on. Oh, nice one. Yay. I always love to see her eating. Beautiful, with the blue and gold leg patterns. Okay, so a little shout out to AH78DOD. He is a YouTuber subscriber of mine that makes tarantula videos as well as automotive videos. So if you want, check out his channel. He's a good friend of mine from the UK. So this one here is a Brachypalma verdesi female, the Mexican rose gray. Boom, there we go. Yeah, abdomen looks pretty large for the species. But as you can see, Kalinka took it without any issues. All right, a beautiful Leon, who is my male Brachypalma erratum, the Mexican flame knee tarantula. Gotta find a nice juicy worm for you. And I think you love it. There we go. Good job, Leon. Certainly very leggy. But he's a beautiful specimen of the flame knee. Chuck Norris in his tarantula form. This is Morris Rose, my male Gramostola rosea red face. Watch this. This is one of my very few rose hairs that has a super appetite. And this little guy is 6 years old. I raised him ever since he was a half an inch spiderling. So remember, I think I remember telling this in several videos. Whenever pet stores tell you a rose hair is 1 year old and it's already an adult, that ain't true. This guy's like 6 years old and still got a lot of growing to do. And hopefully I'll be pairing him up when he matures with Lois, my female, which of course wasn't interested in eating. Wah. All right, Vitipus rigius. I got Piccadilly Circus here. There we go. He did do a little jumping. And there's a spider. See if I can try to put it on macro. Oh, it is a macro. It's just so darn gorgeous. Here's looking at you, kid. Alrighty, my very first controversial tea. It is a hybrid crossbreed between a B. Bumgartneri and a B. Bohmi. And they like to call it the Mexican Orange Beauty. But anyway, this is a confirmed female chimera. As typical of these Brachypelmas, very hungry eater. Has that little dark triangle that you would see on a B. Amelia. Hopefully if tanglesandwebs.com is there, I'll pick up a B. Amelia. I know she's got plenty of them. Alright, Ada Wong. That's the name of my female Brachypelma erratum. This is a Mexican flame knee, of course. Male is Leon. Now this tarantula. Whoopsie. She's got a lot of class because she's a Brachypelma classy Mexican pink. I scared a little bit of Petunia there, but anyway, I gotta get a nice super. There we go. She's a champ when it comes to eating. Come on, Petunia. Food at 12 at 6 o'clock. You want to try the grabbing approach? Oh, I know you love it. Yes, you do. Hey. Let go of my ego. Yeah, there she is. I'm a beautiful tarantula. This is a full-grown 5.5-inch female. Yeah, gorgeous. Lucky to find one here, especially this big too. Whoa, she is awesome. This is Laura. A fantastic 5.5-inch female Gramostola species mole, which is known as the orange fluff tarantula. The camera doesn't do her colors justice. It's a bright red over her body, just like your red phase. And usually she's pretty gentle when it comes to feeding. Come on, Laura. Yes. I named her after the spider enemy in The Evil Within, and the right name that I chose for her because simply she looks beautiful as well as her human appearance. If you ever played the game, she's a Ruvik's sister, red dress, which matches this tarantula, and black hair. Sweet, gentle lady. I haven't really tried to handle her, but with Gramostolas, they're unpredictable, so I think I'll just leave her be. All right, this is Genesis, a immature male. Zenithus imanus, which is the Colombian lesser black tarantula. He's got a bald spot. I'm not sure if he's in premolt. If he is, I'd kind of be amazed since he actually molted a couple of months ago and I didn't really feed him that much and he's ready. But sadly, he is going to be maturing very soon. I know these Xenithus males are really huge in appearance. But anyways, let's see if he'll eat for us. And there's Maggie in the background. You haven't seen her in a while. Okay, okay, good, 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 good. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Very nice. Love the star shape abdomen. Oh, sorry, carapace. Nice pinky colors. Permanent bad hair day on the abdomen, for sure. But he's awesome. Right, this is Talia. She is my Gramostola rosea, or most people like to call it Gramostola pudri, which is basically the normal form of the rose hair, the one that's commonly sold in pet stores with the pink carapace and brown body. So I gotta check for my superworm stash. I know I bought 100 of them. Alright, she's stuck down there. Let's see if I can draw her out for you guys. Okay. Woo! She's pretty hungry. Come on. Come on. There she goes. Nice. Now, she did recently molt a couple of months ago, so had a hard time getting her to eat, but that's what you have to expect from these species, but they're very nice to own and suitable beginner species. Just neglect that. Over time, they do become a little bit more temperamental as they age, and the not eating part scares a lot of new hobbyists, but don't worry. As long as you have a good size abdomen, you have no reason to worry about. Common question that people ask me on YouTube and as well as on Facebook. Alrighty then, now this guy, or this gal, is one of my two LP females. LP stands for Lasiodora para hibana, not Let's Play, which I should be doing sometime soon. Now that I'm out of a teaching job for this year, I should have more time to make videos. Ah, there we go. Now this girl, believe it or not, had escaped on me. Couple of weeks ago. Naughty, naughty. I did find her. Alright, let's see. Woo! Nice! Alright. This is Zelda, my P. Regalis. She's hungry, so we can see her attack. Let's try in midair. Oops. She is a beautiful specimen that gave birth to little Link and Zeldas for us. And I know that you're hungry, so be patient. After I gaze at her majestic appearance. There we go. Nice singing for you. Nice interactive one too. Alright, now. I'm opening a can of worms for this one. This is my other P. regalis. This is Pandora.
And I opened her box. Not a good idea.
How am I gonna do this? Let's see. Let's see if she got it. No, she didn't get it. Oh! Nice!
Grabbed it!
Yeah, this is another P. regalis Indian ornamental.
It's the very first ornamental that I started collecting. Now, I pretty much have most of them, except the P. saphisca highland, which is one of my favorites next to the lowland form. Zelda. Pandora. She's the smaller of the two, she's the largest, he's the oldest.
Prepare a superworm downfall for Espa. She is my leopard gecko. This is the hypo yellowtail morph. And she's gonna eat a lot of them, but super. Okay. Number two.
Right behind you.
All right, let's see if she can see it. Oh, there we go. Boom! Yum. Okay. This time I'm going to use the calcium dust. Let's see. Got some nice juicy ones here. Aw. She missed it. Okay. Last one. Good girl. Nice. The private eye of all tarantulas. Somapos Erminia, Venezuelan sun tiger. Ooh, nice wrestle there. Yep, this is a little inch spiderling. Doing quite well. Now this one here is a Holothele Incy, the Trinidad Olive. Now it's a very special Holothele Incy because it's solid gold. I'm going to call this one Foxy Cleopatra in the house. Oh, nice! Woo! That was my favorite so far. There we go, solid gold. Solid gold. Everything gold is better. Nice. This one here is Princess Peach, my lovely female Gramisola pulchropes, Choco Goldeny. Yes, instant. All right, now we'll try her sister, Wendy. All right, this is Wendy. Same species, Choco Goldeny, Gramisola pulchropes. That's some good eating. Yeah, my poker peas are really good eaters. And so is the species in general. They have great appetites next to the pulchra. All right, so this is Willow. She is my Lacydora fracta, Brazilian smoky gray bird eater. Here we go, Willow. Nice job. One here is Alberto. He is my male Brachypalma albiceps, the Mexican gold red rump. Let's see if you'll... Ooh. Uh-oh. Wrong thing, buddy. Hey, Lego my ego. Oh, I know he's hungry. He is hungry. There we go. Had to help him a little bit there. But he's dropped that gorgeous.
You're a gorgeous little guy, aren't you? Pretty. I won't pet you, because you're not too nice.
Dare I?
The spawn from hell. For Mictopus Cancerides, Haitian brown bird eater, the most offensive tarantula that I own.
Alrighty. That's a nice intro. Alright, so, she's pretty fat, so hope she's gravid. I hope Dimitri is doing well. I haven't really talked with the guy I gave him to. Probably on Facebook at some time. Anyways,
let's see if the spawn from hell eats.
Yep. Told you she's evil.
Yeah. Oh yeah, good show.
Yeah. Nice one. This is a Formuctopus auratus, also known as the Cuban bronze. This is Don Manuel, named after one of the villagers from Resident Evil 4. See if he's hungry. Ah, there we go. Nice one. Not as mean as Isabel, but you'll get to be one day a nice big mature male. Alright, now for my most expensive spiderling that I ever purchased this year. This is a Harpatrica pulchropes, which is also known as the golden leg blue baboon. I guess not really interested in eating, but show you the nice colors of the species, especially when they're adults. They're gonna look exactly like that Embalfuri you've seen, but with OBT like colors. So I can't wait to see this little guy grow up into a 4.5 to 5 inch T. Oh, that sucks. The cricket's way down there. I don't want to disturb it. No. Too bad. Alright, this is a Pamphibedius vespertinus, which is known as the Ecuadorian red-bloom bird eater.
Oh, that was cool.
Almost as good as the HNC gold form, but I think this is even better. Typical of these Pamphibedius species, you have the Christmas tree-like pattern on the abdomen, It unfortunately goes away when it reaches its juvie stage. Nice. Gotta love your Pamphibidius. They're really super good eaters. And highly recommended if you're collecting your tarantulas. Can't wait to see what colors these will be when they grow up. This girl's a fatty. She is my Eupalistris Wagenbergi, which is the white collared. It's like a PZB, but they only grow up to like 4 inches as a female. Males are like 3 inches, they're pretty small. Oh, she nailed that one. Or he. Unsexed, but. Oh no! Poor cricket! Wow. That's gotta hurt. Ooh. Poor cricket. Oh well. Alright, this is a nice tarantula. This is my king baboon, Polynobius muticus. Oh no. There we go. There we go. You haven't seen a king baboon feeding in a while. Here's my specimen, around an inch and a half. It'll take at least 10 years before they reach their full 9-inch size. Really slow growing species, but extremely long lived. Awesome. BBB sling is sure growing up. Still hungry as ever. Sweet. For a couple of Poclotheria hanumavilla simica, the Rameshwaram ornamental. This is Tatiana, my female. Of course, named after the evil within. Let's try her future boyfriend, Sebastian. Boom! Grabbed it. Man, pogies are sure fast. But gotta love them. A lovely beast. This is Mia, my Poclotheria metallica, which is known as the Goody Sapphire Ornamental. Was an extremely rare pokey back a couple years ago. Now that they're pretty common, you can get them for like $100 for a spiderling. I don't know if she's gonna eat, but we'll see. Yeah. Takes it and goes. She thinks it's fast food, but anyway, this is what she looks like after bet 5 years. Seems to have loved the backdrop underneath or back of it, but if she's happy, I'm happy. Nice blue pokey. Now, let's give a round of applause for Allison. She is my freshly molted, almost 5-inch female Poclotheria smithii, which is the yellow-backed ornamental. There she is. She's getting large. Yeah, doesn't want to let her see her pretty colors, but anyway, she's cool. Just love it when they're more visible. This one here is a Poclotheria miranda, Bengal spotted ornamental. You're not going to believe how I named her. Miranda. Yeah, saw that coming, John. Ooh, nice. Yep. Not too bad. Okay, hiding, whoops. Way in the back is my Poclotheria Vitata Cross Ornata hybrid crossbreed. Ghost fringed ornamental. Here's a nice shot of her. Very cool poke. Yeah, I went to go ahead and bought another pink toe, Vicularia. This is a little bit larger than the female that I owned before. So, don't know if she's gonna eat or not, but she's pretty passive. But beautiful nonetheless. Or colors. I believe this could be a name Metallica. I think it isn't a Metallica. Huh. Sweet. Yeah. Definitely, I see white hairs all over the body, so yeah. Nice job, John. Sweet. Alright, another pokey. This one here is a Poclotheria striata, the Mysore ornamental. Yep, grabbed it. Nice female. Well, you look at that. Somopous reduncus. Exec? Really? I think it might be a phantom egg sac, but I might have to call Tarantula Canada to ask them if this spider was really mated. Well, if it was mated, that would be totally sweet. If not, then... oh well, I'll just have to pull the sack out just like I did a T-Gigas couple years ago. So, I don't think I'll be feeding her anytime soon. But that's pretty astonishing. And haven't never bred this one before, so... yeah. Kudos to Misty making a sack. Which I don't think it's viable, but... who knows? This is the very last invert that I'll show in part one. This is a Daemon Diadema, which is the tailless whip scorpion. Wow. That's Dinah, my adult female. Sure is quick, ain't she? Ain't she a pretty beast? Oh yes you are. So cool. So anyways everyone, so this ends part one of Tarantula Feeding video 125. So unfortunately my camera battery is low again, so I'm gonna have to charge it up. And we'll stay tuned for part two of the feeding video, where this row, the bottom shelf, well actually these two bottom shelves, as well as the Nephila clavipeeps. Alright everyone, hope you liked the video and stay tuned for Bat 2.